If you were to go out to the wooden boat school and take the course Bronze Casting for Boat Builders, one of the first things that you would make is a cleat. So I thought it only fitting that the first bronze casting that I make for the boat would be a cleat. So you can see I've come up with a classic Herreshoff design cleat. I thought that was only fitting considering that the Haven is inspired from the Herreshoff 12 and a half. So in this episode, we're not only going to cast the cleat, but you're going to see how I made the pattern, how I invested it, and how I cast it and cleaned it up. So all of that's coming up on this episode of The Art of Boat Building. The plans call for an 8-inch bronze cleat. I was fortunate that several years ago, my daughter gave me a Herreshoff style cleat. This one's made out of stainless steel, and I believe it was for a Father's Day gift or something like that. Now, you would think that perhaps I could just use this as a pattern. Now, the problem is there's a couple of problems. So first of all, it's only 6 inches long instead of the 8 inches. And the other thing is that I'm going to need it to be divided in half so that the pattern will come apart in two pieces. One half will be in the cope of the mold and the other half will be in the drag of the mold. So what I am going to do though is to use this cleat as a reference in order to get the proportions right in making an 8-inch one. So in order to get started, what I did was I took a photograph of the cleat and the from the side and from the top. So what I have here is a print of the photograph that I took. I'm going to measure this, and the length is 6 5/8. So I can now then take this proportion scale. The proportional scale has two discs that spin around, and the inner one has the size of the original, and then the reproduction size. So the size of the original would be our 6 5/8, and then the reproduction size would be the 8 inches. So what we do here is find the 6 5/8 would be right there. We line that up with 8 inches like that. And then it tells here that means that it needs to be enlarged 120%. So I then went to my photocopier and I enlarged it 120%. So once I had my print enlarged, I can now measure off of this. Now you can see that it is 8 inches long. And then I was able to take some critical measurements of where these brackets come into the main part of the cleat. And I figured out that it was 2.5 inches from each side and that they are 3 inches apart and that they are 1 inch high. So earlier I had taken a piece of poplar and I split it into two pieces. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue these two pieces together by putting a little glue on each, just on the ends here, and clamp those together, let it dry overnight. Once I have that done, then I'm going to put it on the lathe. So because essentially the cleat is completely round, and the lathe I'll be able to control really making it round. So the first thing I'm going to do after I get that blank glued together is I'm going to drill holes that will represent where these little feet go into the main cleat. After priming and sanding the part several times, I then put a final coat of some blue enamel on it. One of the things that I was a little concerned about is how small the part is for how big this flask is. So I made a smaller flask out of some plywood. So I got started by cutting down some strips of plywood, and then I used my drill press and cut some about 2-inch shallow holes in the sides of it in order for the sand to stick to the inside really well. Once I got those all put together, I then added some cleats to register the two halves together and have a new flask to get casting with. Well, that's the last screw. I'm pretty happy with that first casting. It came out really nice. Now, I did not go through the entire casting process and explain it in detail, and I'm going to do that in the next episode, as I'll talk about each step and why we do each step and all the way through. And hopefully we'll have another part to cast at that time. So, as always, thanks for watching, and remember, if you're going to make it beautiful.